Hello and welcome to another episode of Hump Day Hymns here at Trinity St. Andrews United Church in Renfrew, Ontario. I am Mike McCormick. I am the musical director here. And today we're going to look at the influence of classical composers and classical compositions in both hymns. So what I'm going to do, I've picked a few of the big rock stars of classical music. And I'm going to play a hymn or two, that's in our hymn book, and then a piano piece. Now, what this is going to do is, it's going to be a little intimidating for me because it's recording these pieces, especially the piano ones, all on their own, with no one to look at except like this impersonal camera, means that it really highlights every single mistake, and if I put this on the YouTube, it's like immortalized forever, every single goof up I do. But hey, that's what we do. We're honest here. I don't know how to edit out the mistakes yet. I could do it audio, if never mind. So the other thing that I think is interesting is that the piano pieces are all going to be taken from this here Piano Classics book, which again was a donation to the thrift shop. So I've received a lot of music over the past couple years from the thrift shop. Some of it quite bizarre. I now have the sheet music for Stairway to Heaven in case someone is going to work on their Stairway to Heaven. So I think I'm going to start with Handel. The piano piece is called Largo, and it's kind of, I use it a lot at funerals. It's got a very slow and very somber pace. And yet the hymn I'm going to play is Thine is the Glory, which is an Easter rousing thing. So showing how Handel is able to go with a full range of emotions. Thank you. So Franz Schubert did many, many piano pieces. I'm going to play one called Serenade, which you might have heard. I think a lot of piano students are forced to play this one. And the best piece we have in our hymn book is actually one of the communion settings. And I think this communion setting is used many different places. I know the one time I played at Our Lady of Fatima in town, they used the exact same setting. So here's a Schubert. So what I'd really like to do here is show like maybe a lesser known classical composer. So this is by a guy named Beethoven. No, it's Ludwig von Beethoven. Beethoven is maybe the greatest composer of all time. He composed for symphonies, he composed for string quartets, lots of piano music. So the best known hymn is Joyful, Joyful, which is, you know, Ode to Joy from his Ninth Symphony. Before lockdown, I got to see this performed at the NAC with like 100 voice choir and a full symphony orchestra. It's pretty big, pretty loud, which, you know, he was deaf, so he needed to write loud music. And the piano piece, Beethoven also wrote 31 piano sonatas of all sorts of variations on it. And this is probably a very well-known piece. It's the opening of the Moonlight Sonata. But there are other movements to this sonata, and I don't know them. And I'm working on another Beethoven sonata, and I'm not even ready to butcher it on camera yet, but I will. Robert Schumann. I don't know very much about Robert Schumann, and I didn't investigate it. So let's see. What's the piece? I'm going to redo this one. So Robert Schumann is another composer that wrote a lot of piano music. The piece I'm going to play is the Traumerei, and I think it's called the Happy Farmer. So I'm going to play two Schumann pieces, hoping that I get one of them close to right. And the tune is called Canonberry. So in this particular 416 in the Voices United, besides being the area code for Toronto, it's also a Charles Wesley hymn called Forth in Your Name, O Christ. But like I say, the tune is Canonberry, which is used, I think, two, maybe three times in our hymn book. Oh, that's all. Hopefully that's it.